Hello and welcome to another video of Abstract Thesis series. And in today's video, we are going to discuss the newly released feature of persisted sorting for field parameters. If you might be aware that in the field parameter, when we used to change the categorical variables, the sorting was getting distorted. And that is why some time back I created this video, which you also appreciated, that how can you keep the axis sorting intact. But now there is no need of this video because in May 2025 release, we got this feature. I am in Power BI's May 2025 feature summary. And if I scroll down, one of the feature which got released this month is persisted sorting for the field parameters. This is a preview feature. Let me click on that and showcase you that. Let's read the release notes. Field parameters are a great way to provide flexibility to your report users. However, as much as you like them, there are a couple of recurring pieces on the feedback. One of them is to do with how the changes in the selected value by field parameter reset the sorting of the visual. This month, we are resolving this by persisting the sorting even when you change the field selected by the field parameter. For instance, your visual can use field parameters to display the total sales based on the selected field and, for example, the selected category. So notice I sorted it by category ascending. Now let's switch the field parameter to class, the category and the contrast all on new behavior. Previously, when we used to change, it used to change the sorting on the major, but not from this month onward. And previously, I have given you a workaround for the same. As soon as you switch the field selected by the field parameter to something else, the sort order of the visual would change to your visual would be sorted by total sales descending, which is the default sort order for this type of visual. Starting this month, that is no longer the case and the sort order will persist and the visual will be sorted by the field selected in the field parameter even after it is switched. So this was the feature which you were looking for long. There is a workaround which I already suggested, but no more need of the workaround. We have to say that video is no more needed now, but good thing is we got the feature by default. So I'm here on the Power BI desktop and I'm going to quickly showcase you this feature. And in this video also, I'm using the end-to-end 12 with Visual Calcs file. This file is the outcome of the 20-hour Learn Power BI video. And it is using my common sales model with the sales table joined with item, customer, date, and geography in one to many, where all the dimensions are on the one side and sales table is on the many side. So let's go back to the report view, add a new page from right bottom, green or the teal color button plus sign. As I have right now collapsed all my panes, you are not able to see the panes. The time has come to open up those panes, data, build, panes. Let me quickly create a field parameter for your reference. So what I'm going to do is to do that, I will go to the top and there I will go to the modeling ribbon and there you will see the option for the new parameters in the middle of the screen. New parameter, fields, and in the field, I'll call it axis new. I already have axis one as you can see. And here I will drag different dimension categorical fields like brand, category, subcategory, name, and let's go ahead and bring something from different dimension to test, and that is state and city. Now let's create this, and while creating, I would also like to add a slicer onto this page so that my work is easy. So let's create it. We'll get a slicer, a table will be created for field parameters as you know. I have already explained this feature multiple times, so you can watch the related videos on the same topic on my channel. So let me do a little bit of adjustment. Let me also add a visual quickly. I clicked on the empty space and I would like to create a cluster column chart. And in this cluster column chart, on the x-axis, I would like to use this new field parameter. So I will go down from the axis new. I will drag axis new on the x-axis and then I will go up and drag net on the y-axis. And as you can see, I am getting the visual by brand Right now nothing is selected, and that is why you are able to see a hierarchy here. So let's select something. Let's select brand. And now once we select the brand, I will go ahead here on the ellipses icon, the three dots, and I'll sort it by brand. Now it is sorted on the brand, and let me also sort it ascending. So now it is sorted on brand ascending. Let's change it to category. And as you can see here, is this is category 1, category 2, category 3. It is not now sorted by the net value, because the net value is highest for the category 2. Let's check it for subcategory. Same, it is sorted by subcategory now. Let's go to state. It is sorted by state, Alaska, Arizona, California, and so on. City name, same way, it has been sorted alphabetically only on the axis. This feature has now become the part of the default sorting of the categorical axis, even when you are using field parameter, so sorting is persisted. So why don't you go ahead and try this out, and do let me know what else you want me to cover in this particular series. Thanks for watching this video. Thank you. Keep watching, keep asking questions in comments, subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon so that you can get notification for new videos. Thank you.